Now here we are at the topic of the escalation team, and the escalation team is very similar to the group. The group was this, you know, this unordered list of delivery endpoints. What's the difference between that and an escalation team? The escalation team is not unordered. It is very specifically ordered. As you can see here, you know, the order is very important because what we're doing is, given the criteria that we see, you know, as defined in the escalation team, we're going to go ahead and order this in a specific way and then escalate it after X number of seconds and then have certain behaviors depending on whether it's acknowledged or not. So, you know, it's, you can just think of this as an ordered group in which we first send it to the first person in this order and then we escalate it. How often do we escalate it? Well, through this escalation period, okay, every 30 seconds. In this case, that's kind of a bad example, but you know what we're doing here, you never expect to get some response that quickly. But you can set this for, you know, 10-minute differential so that we escalate it 10 minutes at a time to the next person on the email distribution. Now, I say next person. That's a misnomer. That's not really what we should be talking about here, to the next delivery endpoint. Because remember, this could be a web service. This could be something that goes out to some other delivery endpoint that is not associated with a user. So it's not necessarily something that's it's not a user here. It's a delivery endpoint. So this is an ordered list of delivered endpoints. Now, what happens if we get to the very end of the escalation and it's not acknowledged? Well, as you can see we've done here, we simply ended the escalation. We say, okay, we've tried everybody, and we're just going to stop at that point. Or you can specify for it to repeat, or you can and repeat X number of times, or you can simply say, keep repeating the escalation over and over again until it's no longer an active notification. Now let's just take a look at a notification that actually is being sent to an escalation team. As you can see, once every 30 seconds, we're going to move on down the line and indicate that we've gone to the next person that receives this. So as you can see, this has been escalated. And that's going to go ahead and continue, in this case, until the a state is no longer met, and so when we no longer have that triggering condition. So this is an example of an escalation team in which we're going from one ordered delivery endpoint to the next, you know, based on the criteria that I specified in my escalation team. Again, back to this escalation team, here's the order in which we're sending this, and here are the details on how we're going to be sending that. Now, I do want to point out something about the Office Communication Server delivery endpoint. If you are using one of these OCS channel delivery endpoints or delivery channel, then if the presence shows us in Office Communicator that the, you know, the person that we're sending this to is not available, we will not wait that escalation period. So the system's smart enough to see that that person's not available, and it'll go ahead and move right on to the next person on that list. So we are tightly integrated with Office and this OCS delivery channel so that you can just go down the list to find whoever is available.